Well, growing up in Southern California, I thought that snow plows were those things that people that weren't smart enough to live in Southern California needed during the winter time, because, you know, like winter in Southern California is like, a blustery 45 or 50 degrees. Well, now I found that maybe it wasn't the smartest place to live, and I no longer live in Southern California. And now where I live, it does snow during the winter. And now I say, if you live where it snows and you're not smart enough to have a snow plow, well, then something's wrong. Maybe then you should go live in Southern California. All that said, if you live on some property, you need to clear the snow in the wintertime. Probably the handiest thing I've had, because I've tried a lot of different snow removals, from the shovel, yeah, as long as it's only a little area, to a snow blower. Well, if you've used a snow blower, you know that if anything other than a small sidewalk in a still day, it's going to blow snow all over you. To my Caterpillar, which has an enclosed cabin and a heater, but it's big and it just pushes the snow, and it's not very fun. That I found the quickest, fastest, and most fun way to get the snow removed from my driveways, my property, and then, of course, once you have a plow, you start moving to other people's houses and do this, you know, the good turn thing, then don't let them know that you're really enjoying yourself. An ATV with a snow plow is the best way to go. Now, if your ATV is set up properly, you've already got a winch, right? We've already said this a bunch of times, that if you're going to use your ATV for anything, for work, for exploring, you really should have a winch on it. So if you have listened to me and you already have your winch on your ATV, putting a plow on it is going to be a piece of cake. Now, we've got the new plow from KFI, and pretty easy to bolt on. It comes in some pieces, so you've got to start putting this stuff on, but it's really quite easy to do. The first thing you got to do is put the mount, the specific mount for your ATV, on to your ATV. And all that does is, typically, like on our Suzuki King Quad 750 here, was this, the mount fastened to the frame with four U-bolts. Now, you can take the skid plate off and fasten it, which would have been a piece of cake to do. We like to leave our skid plate on and then bolt it, so we had to drill the holes through the plastic in the skid plate to put the U-bolts on and then squeeze our fingers in there. So it took a little bit of time to get that right, but again, it's four U-bolts and that plate is on. One of the things I like about the KFI mounting plate is the mounts don't hang down very far, so it's conceivable you could just leave that thing on all year round. I'm going to do it and just see if I bang it up too much, because some of them used to have big long tabs, and now the KFI has real little heavy tabs, long tabs. I think they're going to survive my riding through the rest of the year. Now, once you get that mount on, you just have to assemble the blade to the push tubes. Now, the push tube, the first thing you got to do is, once you lay this push tube out, first thing I'm going to do is mount the blade to the push tube. And it just takes these four big bolts that you're going to just put through with the washers to put it into place. Now, once you've got the blade to the push tube, the next thing you're going to do is fasten the spring to the blade. And the springs just control the amount of pressure that it's going to have to push before it's going to release some of the snow. So just hook the springs in their slot, pull them up, and then you've got the adjustable eye bolts to adjust the spring tension on the plow blade itself. Then in addition to that, you can adjust the angle that you want the plow to sit at. I set it at the recommended, I think it's 3 degrees that they've got it. But it's adjustable, which is a nice thing, so you can adjust the angle of attack of this. Once you get that done, you can set the feet on the plow, so that you can adjust the surface of the plow, how far it will ride above the surface that you're plowing. Now, one of the things I got to mention in this part of it, a lot of the plows that I've used in the past are those, they have different names for them, but where the plow is smaller on one side and bigger on the other. I think if all you did was plow a Walmart parking lot, that would be perfect. But for me, I'm plowing graveled roads and graveled area in front of my shop here. And what I found is with those plows with a lot more blade on one side than the other is they're heavier on that side. So you try to adjust your plow to where it's plowing the snow down to about an inch, but not plowing up any of the rocks. And it's really hard because that plow wants to sit at an angle simply because it's heavier on one side. So I really like the fact that this plow is the same size all the way across. And then to keep some of that snow from, you know, blowing back over and give you just a little bit more area, there's a rubber flap that you fasten on. And again, it's just some real simple little, 6-7 bolts that fasten that on. And then you're ready to fasten the plow on. Now, what's really cool about this is it only takes two things to fasten this plow on. Slide it under the ATV, put the little pins from the push tube into the mount that you've put on the ATV, and then hook the winch up to the plow. I've used a lot of plows in the past, and some of the places where you were to hook the winch up, it's like they never thought about that or something. It's like you were supposed to use something else, use some kind of big hook, or I don't know. It just didn't seem to work. This has three really nice locations, a great place to hook your winch up, so it's a piece of cake to do it. The plow is adjustable for angle as well as the pitch here. Again, easy to put together, so you can't be intimidated by that. Pretty easy to put the mount onto your ATV, and then once you've done that, it's as simple as unhooking the winch and pulling the two pins to take your winch off, to take your plow off when you're not using it. And then when you get ready to use it, just pull up behind it, get it lined up, stick the pins in it, pull your winch out, hook it up, and you're ready to go. You can get more information on the KFI full line of plows and the mounts for the different ATVs and UTVs, and all the other accessories they've got, especially if you don't already have a winch, from their website. Check it out. I can tell you we have used KFI products for a long, long time, and I am really, really pleased with the quality of all their products that we've tested, because we have not had a single problem in all the winches and other accessories, mounts. Everything bolts on just as it should and works, and as long as we've had them. So like I said, I haven't had one bit of problem. Check out their website for more information. Till next time, I guess I'm going to sit around and wait for it to snow more so I can plow again. Till I see you again, God bless.